Hey guys, what's going on? This is Oleg with Winter Bellevue Comments. Today is raining outside in Seattle. It's gloomy and weather is not the greatest one. And today one of those days when I like to record video and give you some good tips. I have friends who's living in a nice neighborhood and they're renting right now because they cannot afford to buy property there. And also I have friends who can afford to buy property in a nice neighborhood, but they're afraid to buy property because they're afraid to get 30 years mortgage. And also I have friends who, millennial friends, who just finished college, just finished university, just got a job, have a huge student loan, and maybe have $15,000-$20,000 on saving account, but never invest before and doesn't know how to start on investments. If you're one of those people, stay tuned and this video is for you. Today we'll talk about money, and be more specifically, we'll talk about how to utilize leverage on borrowing. Not every borrowing is bad. Bad borrowing is when you get credit cards and when you maximize those credit cards, go to expensive vacation, come back from vacation and see you have to repay your debts and you don't have any money. That's a bad debt. But sometimes debts can be good, and good debts, I'm assuming those debts when you get money, get somebody else money to make more money for yourself. And that is very possible. And I'm assume you have a job, and I'm assume if you have student loan, you finish university or college, and have at least some money for investments, you have to have at least $10,000 or $15,000 to start those investments. And basically it's two types of investments. First type of investment when you invest your own money, 100% cash. And second type of investment when you use somebody else's money, like bank money, and just put it, some of down payment can be like 3.5%, can be 20%, and you use leverage of borrowing. And I will explain you how that's work. Example, like let's say if you invest $100,000 to buy stocks or real estate property, and you receive a 10% profit end of the year, so it's about $10,000, you have 10% return on your $100,000 investments. We call this cash on cash return. And if you buy $100,000 property, put $20,000 as a down payment with 4% mortgage payment, that's about $3,200 a year. So you're basically gonna make, if you rent property for $10,000, you're gonna make $10,000 minus $3,200, $6,800 a year profit. And if you calculate cash on cash return, 34% on your investment. That's much better investments. And that's why many people like to get a loan, and especially when the low interest rate. And if you get a loan from the bank, regardless of economy, regardless if you're gonna have recessions or not, your interest rate will be secure for 30 years, it's gonna be fixed rate, and banks will never tell you, repair your mortgage, give us money back within 30 years if your loan is secure for 30 years. It's very secure and very safe investment. And let's talk about cost of the loan for 30 years. For example, if you take loan for 3.52% and for 30 years you have to pay for the mortgage, I'm assuming buying property for $500,000, your yearly payment will be $17,500 a year or $1,458 a month. And if you rent this property and receive an income, you can write off up to 50% on the interest payment for the property, and 50% from $17,500 a year, that's about $8,750 a year write-off on your mortgage. This is why many people love to borrow money from the bank and don't like to buy for cash. So technically, if your mortgage is 3.52%, after taxes, you will pay 1.76% for the bank. And this is very low payment because you can invest your money, put in any saving accounts, and many banks right now you can make even more money. And this is not all. Another big player in this is inflation. Official inflation in 2019 was 1.76%. And what that means, when the government needs more money, they basically prints more money, and more money they print, less money will be worth in the future. And technically, like, you take like $500,000 loan today's money, and you repay like 30 years from now, those money probably gonna be worth $350,000. And that's the same thing, like your bank tell you, here you go, take $500,000 today, but please give us $350,000 after 30 years. And again, if you come back to our calculations, if your mortgage interest 3.52% for the mortgage, and we subtract after property taxes deductions 1.76%, and we subtract 1.76% inflation in 2019, if you get a mortgage right now, you pretty much getting free loan or free money. But that's not just all. Another big player in this is appreciation. And average appreciation in the United States about 4% a year. Our local area, we do have recorded appreciation for last 15 years about 6%. And if you purchase property with $500,000 and appreciate about 6% a year, so it's about $36,000 a year from on a $500,000 property, so you're gonna receive $360,000 in 10 years. And this is like no-brainer if you use leverage of borrowing money in the right location with the right agents. You're actually gonna make a lot of money. If you guys looking to do that and doesn't know how to start, you see my number on the screen, reach out to me. I'll do private consultations, free consultations, help you in specific situations and invest in your future. Even if you don't have a lot of money, maybe you have $7,000 and maybe your friend have $11,000. And if you live in an apartment renting right now, and if your friend renting as well, you can buy property together even with 3.5% down payment and move in this property, stay there for 10 years, sell it, and you can make $360,000. This property you can split between both of you. Nonetheless, you're not living with parents for free. You need to pay for somebody for living. So you're paying for your landlord if you're renting right now, or you can pay for the bank for your mortgage and use leverage of borrowing to generate your future wealth. I hope this was helpful for you guys. Smash like button, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and stay tuned for my future episode. Make a fantastic week.